फाइव सेकेंड, टू सेकेंड, रेडी। देयर आफ्टर द वक्फ बोर्ड विल वंस अगेन एग्जामाइन द लिस्ट सेंट टू इट विद ड्यू एप्लीकेशन ऑफ इट्स माइंड एंड ओनली देयर आफ्टर द सेम विल बी सेंट टू गवर्नमेंट फॉर नोटिफाइंग द सेम इन द गजेट। सिंस द लिस्ट इज प्रिपेयर्ड एंड पब्लिश्ड इन द ऑफिशियल गजेट बाई फॉलोइंग aforementioned procedure, there is no scope for the plaintiff to get the matter reopened by generating some sort of doubt about survey commissioner's report. Since the surveyor's report was required to be considered by the state government as well as Waqf Board as the case may be prior to finalization of the list of properties to be published in the official gazette, it was not open for the High Court to conclude that the surveyor's report will have to be reconsidered. On the contrary, surveyor's report merges with the gazette notification published under Section 5 of the Waqf Act, and such the property in question does not find place in the gazette notification published under Section 5 of the Waqf Act. If anybody, including the Waqf Board or the plaintiff, was aggrieved by such non-inclusion of the property in the list notified, and the aggrieved person should have raised the dispute under Section 6 within a period of 1 year from the date of publication of the gazette notification in the matter. It is time that a high power body was appointed to hammer out a national scheme of application having integration as the basic aim and to implement it sympathetically. The present method of meddling at every stage of education, the present climate in which we are not clear about the medium of instruction at different stage, is causing concern to the parents, to the pupils, and weakening the country in the process. This is a major problem at this stage of the development of the country. Then, Mr. Vice Chairman, I would pass on to the Ministry of Transport and Communications. According to this ministry, we are to build a system of national highways, provincial or state highways, and integrated system of communications from the village upwards, but the central government is concerned with the construction of national highways. Among the priorities which have been fixed by the Honorable Prime Minister in the budget of 1987-88, rural development and poverty elimination programs have been given a special emphasis. The setting up of the National Labour Commission for improving the lifestyles and economic standards of the unorganized labor in our rural areas is due to his insight and imagination. It shows his concern for the poor and his socialistic way of thinking. According to an estimate of a national newspaper, about 20 crores of people fall in the category of agricultural labor, and to whom the basic necessities of life, that is food, clothing, and shelter, are not available even today, and they must get these facilities on a priority basis. I want to congratulate the Honorable Prime Minister for paying his attention to that section and for making special efforts to uplift them by setting up this commission.